A couple of years ago, you could say the phrase, hey, you look $1 million. And that was a nice phrase. But now, thanks to the real estate market absolutely going off its tartars, have you seen the shitholes that are now sold for $1 million? Yeah, if someone says now you look like $1 million, what they're really saying is you need to be rebuilt from the ground up. You are a cracked end. That's what you are.
Please welcome Dave Thornton!
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Who would have thought? A middle-aged man complaining about the property market.
Yeah, that is.
What a shock for everyone.
So I don't know what I meant to say. If you can't say you look $1 million anymore, if that's not a compliment, what are you meant to say?
What do you mean to say?
Yeah.
Swipe right, bro, and just jump in.
I feel like I'm not... I don't want to say that.
You don't want to?
No, not right now, no.
What about he's got good bones? That's what you, that's how you describe a house, right?
Looks like you got a nice rumpus room there.
Now, Thorno, I live near you. I've seen you out on your bike quite a lot. Now, are you going... Is this a health phase or a midlife crisis? What's going on?
No, this is petrol is more expensive than truffle oil. So I am riding around at this point in time just to save some money. But it's amazing just riding around. I mean, I get it. On the streets of Melbourne especially, any city in this country, you're the lowest ranking officer.
Of course. Yeah, right.
You know, I get it. Like, I got to give way to buses, cars, I get it. But, man, even pedestrians are like...
And the streamers you have in the handlebars don't go under respect.
That's pretty sick, bro. The glitter I'm throwing behind me is pretty rad. But the thing is, what I'm realising when I'm riding around is I don't judge anyone on their bike. Like, I couldn't care less, but I do judge people on the equipment they're wearing while they're riding.
Okay,
so what's all right? What is it?
Well, I'm not even talking about the middle management that goes down to Mornington on a weekend the Peloton.
Yeah.
I don't care about those guys who are like 55, got a BMI of 32, and they're like, I'm going to put Lycra on. You're like, cool, I'm going to pour acid on my eyes. Hope I don't see that. That is brutal. I'm talking about those guys, you know, when they wear like the helmets with the fluoro cross vest or the tags out the top.
Yeah.
You know, and they look like they're lost at sea. Do you know what I mean? But the one that I love the most is the guy in construction high vis. I'm just like, lost your license drink driving.
I've seen a few.
I love that guy.
Yeah, so you've been on the road a lot this year. Interesting characters encountered along the way?
Is there what?
Yeah.
You know, I did a gig recently because I'm in my 40s now. Stop it.
You've got a great rumpus for him.
Good bones, mate. Good bones. And I invariably ask the audience. I'm like, all right, who's in their 40s? Cheer, whatever. And then who's in their 20s and 30s? And then I went to move on. And this hand shot up at the back of the room. I was like, oh, okay. And this girl went, you didn't ask if there were teenagers in, because I'm 19 years old.
Oh.
And, like, I was just gobsmacked at the confidence
of
someone at 19. Like, I grew up in the 80s and 90s. Like, if I had an opinion at 19, my dad would be like, no, you don't. Shut up. And plus, I don't think a 43-year-old man should be on stage going, are there any teenagers in?
Even with those bones. Yeah. Still a good one.
Hey, in the green room...
You want to jump on the bike with the streamers? This is pretty cool.
In the green room, you said you had a bone to pick with me. I thought, well, mates, what's going on?
What's this about?
I'm so glad I am on national television now, just airing my grievances.
Oh, no.
What's about
the beard? What's going on here?
Beard beats stubble. But anyway, go on.
Give me some time. But, mate, well, what happened was, this is a little while ago, I was on my social media, flicked it open in the morning, and there was like 500 comments. Oh. And I know where my profile's at. That's way too many.
That's good for anyone.
And there were like death threats and those skulls and those clown faces all over my social media. And I'm like, what is going on? There were even messages under like posts I've done of my kids, like just going, oh, so I was like, this is a lot. And what I found out is, you know the Korean boy band BTS?
Yeah, BTS. Yes.
I always get it mixed up with the Bottle-O, BWS. But, but it seemed like I used to host a clip show on another program, another channel, and we'd done a thing about that boy band and their fans got a hold of it because we were kind of taking the mickey out of them and they went ballistic until I looked it up and said that was the season Nick Cody hosted.
Oh! Yeah. So it's your fault.
It was my fault that he was getting death threats.
Yeah, I was getting, but then I said Nick Cody hosted that, and they all went, "Oh, sorry," and just deleted them all.
Yeah,
and I was saying, I was
getting DMs going, "Man, you're so hot." I'm like, "Thank you."
I was saying to my partner, "I'm like, these are people from like the good side of Korea. Could you imagine like the North Korean fans of boy bands from like DMZ or whatever it is?"
Did you patch it up? Your mates are getting out? Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna get out of here. Dave's brand new special, Don't Ask, is out now on YouTube. Can you please thank Dave Thornton?
Yay!